Hi everyone, and today we'll be programming a multipick application using the Robotiq Palletizing Solution. In this case, instead of using one gripper per box, we'll be picking two boxes with a single gripper. So, before I start getting into the programming, I'll just have a look at the setup I have here that's needed for a multipick. First off, you'll need two different box sensors. So one to detect each box. I have those connected in my UR controller, and I also went ahead in the installation and gave each of them a name so that it's easy to program later on. The second thing I'll do before starting to program is I'll actually have to combine the signal from both of the box detectors in order to send a single signal to the robot, because that's what the software requires when we're picking two boxes. For one single box, it's not a problem because we only have one detector to know if a box is there or not. To do so, what I suggest, and there's different ways to do it, but this one requires only one wire, a jumper wire, that you combine between an available digital output and an available digital input. And then once those two are connected, I created a thread on the side in my program, as you can see on my screen, where I will be setting the digital output to high once both box sensors have been activated. And this will then give me a digital input, my digital input number 3, that I'll be using as the signal for the robot to know when two boxes are ready to be picked. All right, so the setup is ready to go. Now let's start programming the robot. So I'll go here and grab my palletizing node. Here we go. And before we do anything else, we'll start by going into the setting and activating the multiple box type. So you'll see this checkbox right here, which opens up a menu that we'll get to later on. For going there, we'll go back to our boxes. And the first difference you'll see compared to a regular application is that now you have box types. What's a box type? A box type can be one box, can be two boxes together to make a group, could be one box of a size and a second box of a different size. The idea is that a box type is the dimension of the group that the gripper needs to pick. In our case, we'll have one box type that's going to be for a single box. That's when I pick only one box. And we'll have one box type that's going to be for a dual box. Dual box. And that's when I'll be picking two boxes at a time. Now, when we go inside the menu, you'll be familiar with this. It's like you have for a regular application. So I'll put the dimensions of my box. In this case, I've measured them ahead of time. So I'll just add them here. And the weight. And then I'll set the grip position. So like you do with a regular application, in this case, we are going to grab the most at the end of the conveyor, and we'll go ahead and position our gripper. Now, I want to make sure I'm centered as much in this direction as this one. This looks good. We'll grab that and use it as our position. Then we'll go back and we'll do the same thing, but for the dual box. So I'll go here, edit. And then because it's a dual box, my width stays the same, but the length is double. So here I was at 410, we're gonna be at 820 millimeters. And then the height stays the same. However, the payload is doubled because again, we have two boxes. Now let's set the grip position. So I'll use the active drive to bring my gripper right in between the two of them. Make sure they're centered and that the cups are compressed. Here we go. So the position for one box has been thought. The position for the two boxes the other have been thought. I have the different dimensions. The information on the boxes are completed. Next, I'll go back into settings and I'll let the robot know which signal tells it if there's one box available or two. So in the single box, my digital input is the zero, the first one here. However, in the dual box, we'll use what we've configured in the thread below and actually use my digital input three, which is the combination again of the two different signals together. And what you'll notice also is there's this box center offset from TCP. When you're using only one gripper, this is not something you have to change because the centered that you're picking is always the same as the tool. If you had two grippers, then if you were picking it two boxes or one box, it'd be different. Now that that's configured, you should also define the conveyor to avoid collision. It's a good practice that makes sure your robot has all the information about its environment. Now, once done, we can move on to the pallet, which is the same as what you would do on a regular application. I'll be just using the left one in this presentation, but go ahead and use both if that's what your application requires. Then when it comes to the pattern, that's where you'll see there's another difference compared to the regular application. So I'll come in here and then you have this drop-down menu where you can select your two different types of boxes. So I have my single box and my dual box. I'll start by adding a dual box that I'll turn around and I'll just put centered on my pallet. Then I'll add the single box. Just like that. And now a neat thing to notice is that depending on which type of box you're selecting, the other types of box are grayed out. And this is really useful when you want to have a quick look at how many type of box you have on your pattern. All right, so if I wanted to, I could add another pattern for the next layer. I could add more layers. I could edit the layer sequence, but we're gonna keep it simple for now and just keep to one layer with one pattern. All right, so my box has been defined. My palette has been defined. I've told the robot what the pattern I want. What's left is to tell the robot what happens when you want to grip the box. So in our case, we always want to just activate the gripper. So for that, I'm going to add a set node and my digital output to high, which will activate my gripper one. And then when we're at the release, again, we're gonna do a set gripper one, but this time we're gonna turn it off. And so no matter if you're picking two boxes or one box, the gripper will just turn on, grab what's underneath it, and then bring it to the pallet. So everything on the left seems to be complete. There's no more yellow lines. So we'd be ready to run the program and see how it turned out. We might not need it in this particular application, but it's important that you're aware that a script function is available to let you know which type of box the robot is currently gripping, which is something you might want to use if you, for example, have a counter for the number of dual box you have versus the number of single box. Here's an example of how you could use it. So in my gripper here, I'll add an if statement, and here in the function, there's a script that is called get current box type. When you're using it, you'll need to put beforehand the name of the type box you want to get the information on. So for example, I'll add the dual box, which was one of the box type I had. And then I'll add a logical marker this way. So if the current box type I'm picking is the box type dual box, then I can have a result, which could be whatever you need, whether a counter, a truth or false, or an action, depending on your application.